For almost 60 years, if it had an engine and two or four wheels, it's raced here at Mosport. But as we saw in a previous episode of Motoring TV, Mosport welcomed for the very first time Canada's newest racing series. It's called the Micra Cup, featuring the Nissan Micra. Now, as we've seen, Nissan is convinced it can sell cars because of this series, despite the fact it's Micra against Micra with the same specifications. Okay, fine, but what exactly does grassroots mean? And does a series like the Micra Cup mean as much to the Canadian racing scene as it would to Nissan Canada, who at the end of the day have one job, and that is to sell cars out of the showroom?
Just as competitive as I've seen anywhere on the open wheel Formula Car ladders and the NASCAR Canadian Series. I mean, there's some good talent throughout those, but for the cost, it's tough to beat, really.
This series is based on even cars, so everybody is on an even footing. When you graduate from this, if you can go fast in this and you graduate from this, you can go fast in anything.
Honestly, $23,000 for a ready-to-race car. I've been doing this for a long time. I spend that much in tires on other cars in one weekend, and you're actually buying a full car. So I really thought it was going to work, and proof is in the pudding. It works.
To make very simple the difference between the race car and the stock car, the car you can buy at a dealer shop, safety. We empty the interior of the car, roll cage, seat, harness, special steering wheel, extinguisher. Everything else remains stock except the brake pads and the suspension. But engine, transmission, gearbox, everything remains stock.
Racing, it's not about horsepower. We have more fun, I think, than people race in the higher category because the racing is so nice, it's tight. Because the cars are all the same as well, we're racing maybe five drivers for the first place, the whole race, and that makes race very, very exciting races.
The concept of the Micra Cup, it's for everybody. We have people in their 30s, 40s, they had this dream to race, but they were not able to afford it before. And now with the Micra Cup, because it's a reasonable budget, they live their dreams. Canada is a mix. It's very cosmopolitan. The Micra Cup is very Canadian for that.
I was born into a car family because my dad owns a car dealership. So like driving is in my blood. So as soon as I heard my brother was going to do the course, I wanted to do it with him.
I love my sister, so I honestly have nothing bad to say about her. On track, she's a little bit of a pain in the ass, but I mean, she's getting used to the car. So she's got a lot of questions. She's got a lot of things that she wants to learn.
I mean, it's a little competitive because I always want to beat him, but he's really helpful. Like, he helps me around the track when I don't know it. He tells me where I need to go faster, where I don't need to brake, where I need to brake, stuff like that.
What am I doing? That's a very good question. What am I doing here? I have a complete lack of talent, and I'm trying to race a car around the biggest, baddest racetrack in North America. That's what I'm doing here. I'm not sure I should be here, however.
Nose to tail.
I went into turn two. I cocked it up. I let off the gas on a slide. It went one way. I thought I had it. It snapped the other, and all of a sudden, it was a come to Jesus moment. I was sliding sideways with the wall that seemed really far away earlier. Really far away. It seemed like miles away. All of a sudden, it's really close, and I'm about to become one with it. It was a big hit. I think what they're doing is they're taking a car that is not obviously a sports car, and then they're thrashing it within an inch of its life on a racetrack. I don't know that they're proving it's a fast car, but they're proving it's a tough car. I mean, I really, really banged mine hard. I hit it hard. Everything's crumpled. And the car's running again today, and I'm racing again today.
My crew, it's very small. My crew chief, it's like my girlfriend, and I'm here with my little girl. If you have a question or if you need help, you just need to go to see other team, and help you, give you some little tricks. If you need some tools or something like that, my toolbox is coming more bigger at each race. So,
I clean the car. I do everything, so by not everything, not the mechanic. I love to have a little part of his dream, so I'm very proud of him. He's good.
It's kind of passion for me, so I can transfer that passion into my customers, and I think it helps to sell some cars.
We're an online community of Micra owners, car enthusiasts, all looking for stuff about the Micras, and with it being a Canadian-only car, nothing in the American market, we've all found each other on this forum. We're here today to watch the Micra Cup races, to see the cars that we drive, only very slightly modified, go around the track here at Mosport.
Well, first and foremost, I'd say it's not the cheapest car, but the least expensive car. So that'd be important to say. But for us, what it's brought to us is that if that little car can do it on a racetrack and be as durable as it is, how can it be? How great can it be for you as a consumer?
For us, it's a big showcase, and we want a very nice race for everybody around the track, our employees, our team, and to celebrate with champagne after it.
You know, I've always said the good side of high fuel prices was that consumers went out looking for more fuel-efficient vehicles, but maybe more importantly, car companies like Nissan, GM, Ford, Kia, and so on responded by building small, fuel-efficient, funky-looking cars that the Europeans have had for many years. But I think what we've really proven this weekend is that even the little guys can flex a little muscle and show a little attitude when they want to. And I think that's a good thing.